Hey, Sushan. What is going on? This morning I woke up. I couldn't stay up to watch Camel Nights. Camel Moon Nights, so I decided to hit the hay, woke up. So I was watching it this morning. They had a clip. Something was released. This company here. Niam. They're a marketing company. They make videos. They do advertising. Anyway, they made a video, something going on in the Saud family in Saudi Arabia. They are building a line. They're building an arcology. Kind of clever, but at the same time, is it going to work? 9 million people are going to live in this structure. 9 million people. Anyway.
Humanity has existed within dysfunctional and polluted cities that ignore nature. Now, a revolution in civilization is taking place. Imagine a traditional city and consolidating its footprint, designing to protect and enhance.
They took, let's see, they took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, about 14 city blocks and put all the buildings into this one section here. This is the beginning of the line, or the middle. I want to say this is the middle of the line. And it's made up of sections about this size. And each section is as tall as the Empire State Building, I want to say, according to their calculations. I also saw the Eiffel Tower. How tall is the Eiffel Tower? Anyway, so they took all these buildings and just put them in here.
Nature. The line will be home to 9 million residents and will be built with a footprint of just 34.
Well, there's no roof. It's just open, but it's got walls on both sides.
Square kilometers. And we are designing it to provide a healthier, more sustainable quality of.
I'm guessing it's getting its water from this end. Maybe it's getting water from the ground along here. I don't know where this thing goes. It's going through. Are they doing the Buckaroo Banzai thing where they drive through mountains? Because there's water on the other end of this thing.
Life. The line's communities are organized in three dimensions.
So it's going to look like this inside one of the sections. Each section looks kind of like this. It reminds me of Horton Plaza in the 1980s. Just a cluster of stores. Helter skelter, just everywhere. People trying to figure out, I'm over here. Now, how do I get over here? I'm here, but I want to be here. Or I'm in this store, but I want to get up to this store. How do I do that? How many elevators is this thing going to have?
Residents have access to all their daily needs within 5 minute.
Oh, come on. My artifacting. This section here, just from here to here. From here to here is about 5 stories tall. So that gives you an idea of how high this is. If you were to jump, how many suicides are there going to be? People jumping from here to here. Poop. So I can't take it. In Japan, people jump all the time in Japan. It's just a thing.
Walk neighborhoods and the line's infrastructure.
So you can kind of see inside. That's crazy. And then this part down here, I think is the train, the monorail. Super fast. Takes you across the line. from end to end in about 20 minutes or something like that.
Structure makes it possible to travel end to end in 20 minutes with no need for cars, resulting in zero carbon emissions.
The train's going to be using up all kinds. This whole thing's going to be electrified, right? They're using electricity, so they're using carbon. This is a lie. This is just a flat out lie. Because electricity doesn't come from magic. It comes from carbon. Or they're going to have a bunch of hydroelectric stuff going on. Are there any waterfalls? Any man? Maybe that's next. Man-made waterfalls in Saudi Arabia. I think it's just flat there. The water doesn't really move, except for maybe the Nile. That's about it. Is the Nile even close? No.
By leveraging AI technology, services are...
Did I see a flying car just now? Anyway, so you got these people. What are old people get? Old people can't walk. How are they going to get around this area? Is everyone going to be driving in hover rounds? They use carbon. Lots of carbon.
Are autonomous.
Yeah, I think I saw a flying car just now. Let's go back.
By leveraging AI technology.
Yeah, they got these autonomous things that fly around. Delivering packages, maybe? How do they work? How much electricity they use?
Services are autonomous, saving you time and effort.
Oh, what was that? Whoa. I saw a people mover just zoom by.
Yes, saving you time and effort.
Yeah, what? Whoa, get back here, you. What is this? So some bridges you can't walk across to prevent jumpers. So you have to take a ride to go across from one side of the wall to the other. It's for your safety. It's for your own safety. We do this.
Designed by...
Now, did I just see one of those autonomous things do a loop-de-loop? I don't want my pizza doing a loop. This thing did a loop-de-loop.
Designed by...
Yeah, look at that. It just went...
By world-leading architects. The line is 500 meters tall.
Okay, so it's taller than the Empire State Building. Okay. And... It's mirrored. It's mirrored, but it's not 100% mirrored. You can still see things happening inside the place at night on the dark side. But it's mirrored, I guess, to keep some of the heat from getting through the wall. You want some reflection to happen. Helps with the AC that's happening. Natural AC that they're going to be using. Basically, when you have a building this tall, basically what happens is the air rises. It gets hot as hell on these things. So the air rises. So you have this constant, if you have the tunnel tight enough, the air coming out of the tunnel, you could just hover, just put on one of those parachute outfits and just float above the air as it's blowing up at you. That's how hot and how fast the air rises up. Now, I guess they would call that convection cooling or something. I'm just curious where the cold air is going to come from, because it's just going to be circulating hot air.
200 meters wide, 170 kilometers long, and housed within an elegant mirror glass facade. Intelligent solutions create efficiency and year-round temperate microclimate.
I wouldn't count on microclimate to save my life. I want actual climate control, not this microclimate, minuscule climate. It's 100 degrees. I want it down to 70, like now. Microclimate's not going to help you. You're lucky if you'll get condensation on your Diet Coke bottle. Cool air. Okay. Cool air in. Okay. Cool air in. I guess if it's high enough, 500 meters up, if it's high enough, maybe there's some cool air, like a cross breeze above the surrounding mountains. Maybe you get some cool air from the bay or the lagoon or whatever that is out here. And then some of it's going to go down in here. It'll go down on this side because cold air falls, apparently. And then on this end, all the hot air is blown up. No one wants to live on this side. Because every time you step out on your porch or your patio or your balcony, you just have a blasting hot air coming at you from the ground, from below. But the obvious thing, the obvious thing with government-made arcologies, the whole point of these things is that you live desperate lives inside of them. There's a crime, they're crime-ridden, gangs, just thief, graffiti, trash, garbage, things break down. There are so many points of failure to just one section of this thing. Like, who's going to be maintaining the trees that are on the roof? Who's going to be maintaining that? When things begin to leak, the water begins to leak and it's getting into people's homes and crap, who's going to fix that? How many toilets are there in this place? Who fixes that?
With natural ventilation. Energy and water supplies are 100% renewable.
That you don't have like this weird bucket thing near your toilet that recycles all the pee and the stuff, and then just eventually the stuff has to leave the toilet. It just can't be coagulating inside the. It's got to go somewhere. It's going to go somewhere. Is one of these sections dedicated to like bio waste, biohazard? Did they mention hospitals at all? You have 9 million people living in this thing. 9 million people. What's their age? Are they obese? Are they perfectly unfit? Are they intelligent people? Are these welfare recipients that will just trash the place and just break everything they have? Is it going to be crack whores? Who's going to be living this thing? Who gets to live on the top floor? Who gets to live at the bottom? Who decides where they get to live? Who gets, does every living condition, do they all have a window? Do they all have a wall to stare out? And what is the view? What is the view? No matter how high you are in this thing, what is your view?
The line is designed as a series of unique communities.
Why are they unique? What's unique about this section from this section? This one has a Macy's. This one had a Nordstrom. There's a Saks Fifth Avenue was in this one, I think. Who can afford to live here? Is it tax paid? Who? This is the thing. This is the thing you have to. What's the culture? What's the government? What's the political climate? What's going on here? This thing would be its own society. You'd have the people living here would have to have a whole different mindset. Unless they're forced at gunpoint to come live in this place, which is normally how it's done.
Offering a wealth of amenities, providing equitable.
So you got a view of this on one side. Lovely. Then
views and immediate.
You got a view of this on the other side. How exciting. No life on either. There might be some ferrets or something on one side, but there's nothing. There might be some, those weird squirrel mice looking dude things, but they're so tiny. And then, you might have some hawks, their version of the hawk. Or owls maybe flying around, some bats maybe, I don't know. A lot of nothing. It's just rock. Maybe snakes. But snakes are so, you're not going to see any of that from here. You'll just be looking at this going, oh, there's my view. I noticed This looks CG to me. It doesn't even look like a real place.
Access to the surrounding nature.
So whoever lives here has a pretty darn good view. And how do they get access to the area, surrounding areas, I wonder? Oh, here. Oh, yeah, they have to go through a mountain somewhere. How do they, those people, what are they looking at? The underground. They see under the mountain. Or is it like stepping stone staggered? Oh, that would be bizarre. That would be weird. Surely they've figured that out. But it's, what is it? 200 miles, right? 200 miles from this water supply. Is that, what is that? The Red Sea? I can't tell. And then what's on this side? Something. Russia. What's over here?
With 40% of the world accessible within 6 hours, at the heart of the globe's key trade routes, a place for commerce and communities to thrive like no.
Well, 6 hours, you know, you're only 6 hours away from, you're 6 hours away from salvation. There's going to be a movie called The Line. Dystopian future thing, and the line has gone down. No. We have to save 9 million people. Nine million people. And you got the Bruce Willis type character who suffers from asphyxia, and he's going to show up and try to save everybody. Yeah. But don't worry. Help is only 6 hours away. Stay in your home. Stay in the line. Remain calm. Help. Help is 6 hours away. And what help does arrive is the Biden stuff that they don't need. We sent you dog collars, puppy training pads. We sent you kitty litter. We sent you, you know, that's what Biden's going to send these people.
Nothing on earth seen before. The line. The city that delivers new wonders for the world.
Blankets and sleeping bags. And Barbie dolls for girls. Nothing for the boys. Well, that was interesting. I think I'll call this one Roll for Sanity. What the heck?